Chapter 6, Section 4, Voting Turnout. Voter turnout is the percentage of eligible voters who cast a ballot in an election. A long history of political science research has shown that the following demographic factors substantially impact voter turnout: education, age, race, religious affiliation, income level, and gender. Voter turnout also varies by election type and from state to state, since each state produces its own ballot and determines rules for voter eligibility. Demographic factors. Education has a strong positive correlation with turnout. The higher a person's level of education, the more likely the person is to vote. Those with stronger educational backgrounds are generally better able to understand the issues, read about or watch the news, and distinguish among the candidates' positions. Research indicates that younger adults, particularly those under 30, vote less often than middle-aged voters. Those between the ages of 55 and 65 usually have the highest turnout. Then, there is a decline in participation for those over 65. For all education levels and ages, citizens are more likely to vote if they believe their votes can bring about real political outcomes and positive change. This belief is part of a larger concept called political efficacy, which is the citizens' faith and trust in government and their belief that they can understand and influence political affairs. A large proportion of U.S. citizens choose not to vote. Less than two-thirds of citizens actually vote in presidential election years. As groups, both African Americans and Hispanics are less likely to vote than whites. However, the differences are primarily based on socioeconomic status. After the data has been adjusted for income and education, it shows that African Americans are as likely or more likely than whites to vote in many elections. With the exceptions of 2008 and 2012, when African Americans had the highest turnout, whites have generally had the highest turnout. Hispanics have consistently trailed behind both African Americans and whites in turnout. In every presidential election since 1980, voter turnout for women has exceeded voter turnout for men. In fact, women have cast between 4 and 7 million more votes than men have. Women are also registered to vote at higher rates than men. In 2012, nearly 82 million women were registered, compared to 71 million men. In addition, since 1980, larger proportions of women than men self-identify as Democrats. In the 2012 presidential election, women were 10 percentage points more likely than men to vote for the Democratic candidate Barack Obama, 55% of women versus 45% of men. Election types. Voter turnout is normally much higher in general elections than in primary elections. A primary election is a nominating election in which party members choose which of their party's candidates will run in the general election. There are a number of reasons why turnout is lower for primaries. First, in some state primaries, a citizen is only allowed to vote for candidates who belong to his or her political party. This also means that independents, voters not belonging to a party, are far less likely to participate in primaries. Second, because several candidates often compete for the party's nomination, voters are less able to use party identifications to make voting decisions. For example, in the 2016 Republican primary, Republican voters had to sort through 17 major candidates who entered the race. Since researching the candidates takes time and effort, voters may choose to not participate in the primary vote. Lastly, most primary races receive significantly less media coverage than general election races. Turnout can also be affected by the type of primary the state has. Some states have open primaries, in which voters are allowed to vote for candidates from any party. For example, a Democrat can vote for a Republican candidate, or a Green Party voter can vote for a Democratic candidate. During closed primaries, participants must be registered with a political party to vote for one of its candidates. For example, a Democrat can only vote for a Democratic candidate. Most state political parties favor closed primaries because they believe it ensures that the winning nominee is truly backed by the party. However, in closed primaries, independents are not allowed to vote, and those who prefer a candidate from another party may choose to not vote. Both of these factors, therefore, diminish the turnout. General elections, which occur every November, are held to choose among the candidates nominated by the various political parties or running as independents. National candidates for the presidency and Congress, as well as state and local candidates, must participate in the general election to be elected. Given the importance of the general election, voters turn out in much larger numbers than they do for primary elections. Turnout also tends to be higher in the years in which the president is elected than in midterm election years. Midterm elections, which occur in even-numbered years between presidential election years, mainly consist of congressional races. Media coverage for presidential elections is much more intense and widespread, producing more information about the experience, character, issue positions, and leadership potential of the candidates. People are less likely to vote if they are not familiar with the issues and candidates, and voters are less likely to know about congressional candidates than presidential candidates. Given the greater perceived importance of the presidential election, it is not surprising that voter turnout is higher than that of midterm elections. Voting laws. While demographics and political efficacy are influential factors for turnout, voting laws and regulations on the state level are also very important. Registration laws, voter identification laws, and polling place accessibility affect turnout. In general, states see an increase in turnout when they make registering to vote easier, forego strict photo identification requirements, and have more polling locations. Currently, one of the most controversial issues concerns voter identification laws, which require voters to present proof of their identities before casting ballots. More than 30 states have laws that either request or require voters to show a form of identification at the polls. Proponents of these laws argue that requiring identification prevents in-person voter fraud and increases public confidence in the election process. Opponents, however, argue that there is very little voter fraud and that requiring identification adds an unfair barrier to voting for some citizens because those with lower levels of income and education often lack the resources to get a government-issued ID. On the federal level, the National Voter Registration Act of 1993, popularly known as the Motor Voter Law, was enacted to make registering to vote easier. It enables people to register to vote when they apply for driver's licenses and permits registration through the mail as well as at some state offices. The law also prohibits states from canceling a voter's registration due to a failure to vote.